Welcome to your service of worship this morning on the fourth Sunday of Advent here at Emmanuel United Church in Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. It is good to be with you, good that we're together today to give God thanks and praise for this Advent season and for all of the good things God gives us all throughout our week and our year. Let us remember that as we meet together, we begin by remembering the Algonquin people on whose traditional land we now gather in gratitude. We acknowledge their story and their stewardship of the land and the water, the plants and animals through many generations. And we bear witness to the ongoing suffering caused by historical injustices, and we continue to commit ourselves to seeking right relations today. Once again, good morning and welcome, and Merry Christmas. Let us sing together our gathering music. Three times we'll sing, "Wait for the Lord." Let us sing together. Seated. Our life and work. Some announcements are printed before you. Ellen, you can come on forward now if you like. Ellen's going to ring us our next Let's Stay Together Sunday. Thank you.
You need to be a little pushy to build community. Please remember to sign up before you leave today for our first service back here after Christmas, when we will be staying for our Let's Stay Together Sunday with a theme around indigeneity. And our choices are a reconciliation circle led by Kirsten Dumont, Inuit crafts and songs, or a messy church. So please make sure you sign up. Thank you. And for those of you watching at home, we will be sending an online invitation with an email for you to sign up as well. Thanks.
Thank you, Ellen. This is our first of three services of worship today. Our family service is at 5 p.m. and our 7:30 p.m. service tonight, our lessons, carols, and candlelight service. So please come back and continue to celebrate and worship with your church family on this fourth Sunday of Advent and Christmas Eve. The church will be closed from Christmas Day to January 2nd. If you have a pastoral care emergency, please contact Ron McDonald, our new pastoral care provider, at 519-272-3805. His number is there in your order of service. January 31st worship service at 10 a.m. will be led by Jeannie Taylor. Thank you, Jeannie. Jeannie is our lay reader this morning. And our January 7th service will be held at Southminster United Church at 10:30 a.m. It's our gathering together, plus our cluster service, gathering together to worship all together on that day. Boxing Day coffee and conversation opportunity on Tuesday. Coffee conversation on Zoom group will take place. And on Boxing Day, we'll share with each other how we have been gifted this Christmas. So be a part of that and talk to Steve Taylor at publicity@emmanuelunited.ca. Okay, have I missed anything? Any other announcements? Let's continue to share together in our service of worship as we welcome.
Good morning. Please join me in the responsive welcome. Welcome to this sacred place of belonging, where we embrace the sacredness of life and recognize the dignity of each person, spirit-filled with the image of God, the mystery in whom we live and move and have our being. Welcome to all who have no church home, need strength, want to follow Christ, have doubts. Welcome to visitors and to new and old friends. Welcome to grandparents, to mothers, fathers, aunts, uncles, youth, siblings, couples, and single people. Welcome to people of all colors, cultures, abilities, gender identities, and sexual orientations, to old and young, to believers and questioners, and welcome to questioning believers. This day, we are all invited to live into God's love, peace, and justice. May the peace of Christ be with you.
Good morning, Justin and Lina.
Good morning. On the first Sunday of Advent, we lit a candle of hope.
On the second Sunday, we lit a candle of peace.
Last Sunday, we lit a candle of joy.
Today, we light a candle of love.
Okay. Oh God, let your spirit burn in our hearts. Let your heart shine in our world. And as your advent time of waiting for the baby Jesus' birth, come to an end. Let the flame of your love warm the peace where the Christ would be born today. Amen.
Thank you both very much.
Let us sing Hope is a Star from Voices United, number 7.
Till the morning is bright, when God
join me in the call to worship, followed by the opening prayer. We praise God with all of who we are and rejoice in our God of love, who sees and loves all creation. God is mighty. Holy is God's name. God is kind and strong, fair and firm. God feeds those who are hungry, gives water to the thirsty. God remembers the promises made to our ancestors, to Adam and Eve, Abraham and Sarah, Moses and Miriam, Noah, Ruth, Mary, Peter, Paul. We praise God with all of who we are and rejoice in our God of love. Let us worship God. Let us pray. Mighty God, your faithfulness is magnified in the coming of your Son, in the long-awaited birth of the promised Messiah. May we, like Mary, proclaim your greatness as we rejoice in our Savior, Jesus Christ our Lord. Bless what we offer as we give to you our praise. Amen.
Nice. I got a few things I want to show you this morning. I have a skipping rope and some hula hoops and a ball. I'm going to start with a skipping rope, and I need a couple of volunteers to hold a rope. And no, I'm not going to skip the rope, but I just want you to hold the rope. There you go, Natalie and Saffron. There you go. So can you stand up and hold the rope? Then stretch out the rope. There you go. Oh, Natalie, there you go. So as you can see, the rope is a single line. It has two ends. Natalie's holding one end and Saffron's holding the other. Thank you very much. That's good. Thank you. I want to show you the next thing. So the rope has two ends, one end and the other, and thank you both for holding those. This one, this is, what's this? I'm gonna wreck the house here. Okay, this is a ball. Cairo, you wanna hold the ball? If I don't get that, Natalie, there you go. That's good, let's laugh. So the ball is round, isn't it? It's a circle. Yeah, it's a circle, it's round. And you can throw it and play with it, yeah? So round things are good for seeing how things are a circle. They have no beginning and no end, and they just come together. No beginning and no end, they just are. Thank you for that, Cairo. You can hold on to it, that's good. And I have three hula hoops. Who wants a hula hoop? You pass one on, Saffron, because you looked at the, you hung onto the rope. Pass one back, because, yeah, you want one? You want one too? Help Saffron. Yeah, there you go. Nice. Okay. And the hula hoops are what? What shape are the hula hoops?
Circle.
They're a circle. They're round too, aren't they? They're round like a circle. Yeah. And I wanted to show you the circle and the ball, how they're different from the rope, because unlike a rope that has two ends, we know where it starts and we know where it finishes. The ball and the hoops have no beginning and no end. In the church, we think this is what God's love is like. God's love is mysterious and round and big, and it has no beginning and no end. It just is. God's love is forever and ever for us, just like a circle, going around and around and around. It is permanent, and it is wide, and it's forever. And we thank God for that kind of love in our lives. It's continuous, and it's always it has no beginning and no end. So I think love, a circle, is a beautiful image of love for that reason. It has no beginning and no end. It just always will be. It always is. It'll always be with us. It will always be around us. Now, I want the three volunteers holding the hoops to stand with me and imagine. Did anyone not get a hula hoop or a ball or a rope? Someone else want to volunteer? Good. I want you to put the hoops on the ground. We've got lots of space here, don't we? Do we have lots of space? Let's make lots of space. Lay them down on the ground, like this. There we go. Okay, thank you, Natalie. And now I want you three of you to stand inside the hoops. And I wonder if we can all stand inside the hoops. Can we all squeeze inside one of the hoops? Yep. It's going to be tight. My belly's a bit big, so. There we go. That's it.
That's easy. Go with this one.
And as we can see, the hoops are around us, right? Just like God's love is always around us, always with us, always holding us. It's like a big hug all the time. God's love is always with us, like a big hug holding us wherever we go, whatever we do. God's love is always with us. I think God's love is wonderful that way. It's always here and always close to us. Isn't that neat?
No.
Yeah? Like a big circle. So thank you very much. Are you looking forward to tonight? Christmas Eve? Yeah?
No?
Yes? It's Christmas. Christmas is coming. So I'm excited. Tomorrow's Christmas. Tonight's Christmas Eve, yeah. So yes, tomorrow's the day to be excited. You're right. Want to go sit down again? And we'll have our prayer before we go. Thank you, Nan. Okay, put it down for a second. I want you to fold your hands and close your eyes and bow your heads and repeat after me, and we'll say a prayer together, okay? Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for your endless love for us. Amen. Okay. And we're going to sing together our hymn. I'm walking a path of peace, and I'm walking a path of love. We got the...
Our scripture reading today is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verses 47 to 55, the Song of Mary. My heart glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and to his descendants forever. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Savior.
Thank you so much to the choir and to Barb for that beautiful rendition of Mary's Magnificat. A wonderful piece for this morning's service of worship. Thank you so much. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we thank you that you gather your people together to worship on this Sunday morning by the call of your Holy Spirit. May the words of my mouth now and the meditations of all of our minds and hearts be acceptable unto you, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. On this Sunday morning, the fourth Sunday of Advent, the Sunday when we light the candle of love, this year, as we know, happens to be the same day as Christmas Eve, I recall the song of Mary praising God for giving her the blessing of carrying and delivering the Messiah. Hers must have been a magnificent experience to conceive and to carry one who would become the Christ child. Her experience is sung out in praise, as we heard this morning. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. In these weeks before Christmas, in this Advent season, we recall her call, her humility, her responsibility. When she visits Elizabeth and calls out to greet her, the child in Elizabeth's womb, the would-be John the Baptist, leaps for joy. It is then when she sings her song of praise. Music is a higher order of language. With melody and rhythm, experience is expressed more deeply, more wholeheartedly. And whenever we sing the carols of the season, we praise God for giving us Christ and centuries after Christ's delivery into the world, this music where we express our faith. We give back to God the love that God gives us by lifting up our voices in praise or reflection, just as we love one another as a congregation. In 1816, the writer and Austrian priest Joseph Noir was out walking, and he looked out over a very quiet winter-laden town, says composer-conductor John Conahan. Moir wrote the lyrics and played it for the first time on guitar, and choir director Franz Gruber wrote the music to Silent Night. The carol was performed for the first time on Christmas Eve in 1818 as Stille Nacht. Hope my German's okay. Stille Nacht. To this day, it is still the mood maker for concluding the Christmas Eve service with candles. Two of my favorite hymns to sing on Christmas Eve are Hark the Herald Angels Sing and Angels from the Realms of Glory. Charles Wesley's Hark the Herald Angels Sing originally appeared in 1739 in his older brothers John's and Methodist co-founders' collection Hymn and Sacred Poems. Originally titled Hark How All the Welkin Brings, Wesley's and George Whitefield's tune was different than the one we know today. Today's tune is adapted from Felix Mendelssohn's Gutenberg Cantata and was adapted by English musician William H. Cummings. And as soon as I saw that title, Gutenberg's Cantata, I thought of the Gutenberg printing press, which is exactly what it was written to celebrate, Johann Gutenberg's invention of the forerunner to the printing press, the movable type. Angels from the Realms of Glory was written by Scottish poet and hymn writer James Montgomery and was first printed in the Sheffield Iris, a weekly Tuesday newspaper printed in Sheffield, England in the mid-18th century. The most familiar tune to me is Regent Square by Henry Smart, one of three tunes sung before 1928, and it is the tune we still sing most commonly, I would suggest, today. In my first Christmas Eve with you last year, I said the hymns that we sing at Christmas are a part of the collection of the music of the Incarnation, or the music to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ into the world. I also want to suggest this morning that the Christmas music we sing is also music of adoration, music that expresses how much we love our Creator and how that love has been expressed by the infant Jesus' birth. This is, after all, the Sunday of lighting the love candle, also the fourth Sunday of Advent, as I already said. In our Christian church faith, we both believe in and declare the eternal and everlasting love of our Creator God. It has no beginning. It has no ending. It is mysterious in how it somehow, in some way, just became to be. It is infinite, magnificent, and bigger than big, if we can even try, as any mathematician might try to do, to quantify it. I doubt that's even possible. Which means God's love is also deep. My friends, it runs deep, it sinks deep, its roots are deep. This is the experience of our faith, God's deep love. This is a certainty. As God's people, we are called to give our love just as deeply. And there may be times in congregational life when we have to dig deep, to reach deep, and to stretch deep to find that love and ensure that that love is shared and experienced by each and all of us. To seek out that love, to search for that love, to locate that love, to know that love maybe for the first time, or to reclaim that love once again. And my friends, I'm sure we can identify times in our own lives when we are grieving or angry or lost or fearful or resenting, when love seems off in the distance. Maybe we experience that from time to time as a congregation. Maybe we experience that from time to time in our decision making. But again, I ask us as people of faith to dig deep at those times when it seems difficult to experience God's love, to know that God's love is always close by and with us, eternally, everlastingly, forever. Because again, God's love for us is greater than we can humanly fathom. And when we sing the hymns and carols of the season, when we sing these hymns of love for Christ's birth, we do dig deep with our language, with our soul, with our heart, with our emotions, with our expression that goes beyond spoken words, with our faith and with our love for God and our commitment to love one another. May this be our experience on this fourth Sunday of Advent. May it be our experience tonight as we celebrate Christmas Eve. I believe that no matter what we are going through, I pray that we will know that God's love is close to us, eternally and always. May God's love always go with us. May Christ's teachings keep being within us, and may the Holy Spirit keep on inspiring us this day, this coming night, always and forevermore. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let us take a few moments for silent reflection. Loving God, Creator of all of our nights and days, bless us as we, your people of faith, continue to experience your love and find strength and peace in you. Bless all who need your peace this day. Bless us as we dig deep to experience your peace, to bring peace, and to love one another. In Jesus' name, amen.
Our next hymn is from Voices United, number 74, What Child Is This?
Joining Mary in joyful song, our souls proclaim the greatness of the Lord, and our spirits rejoice in God our Savior. So with humble and grateful hearts, let us bring our offerings to God. Dear friends, thank you so much for continuing to bring your offerings to God through your time, your talent, your money, your gifts, your power giving, your givings through power, through email, money transfer, even with your energy. Your presence in this place blesses our ministry here at Emmanuel United Church. Thank you for all that you give, in whatever way you give, for the goodness of your church and the love of God and for one another. Our prayer of thanksgiving and dedication is printed before you. Let us pray together. Holy God, your love is magnified in the gift of your Son, whom you so freely share with us. Bless these gifts that we offer to lift up the lowly and fill the hungry in your coming reign of justice and peace. In Christ's name, amen. Dear friends, let us take these next few moments now on this fourth Sunday of Advent and bring our prayers before God. Let us pray. Dear, gracious, and loving God, thank you for this day. Thank you for all the goodness that you give us through all the days of our year, through all the weeks of our year, through all the seasons of our church year, for the wonder of your love in this place and wherever we go. Wherever we take you, we take your love with us into the world. Thank you so much for calling us to be your church, Emmanuel United in the world. Thank you for all of the time, talent, treasure, energy, goodness, kindness that we offer. Thank you for calling us to serve you faithfully with all that we are and all that we do and all that we have. Dear God, we join our voices with Mary this day. She celebrated God's greatness and sung of God's blessing for all who are poor and oppressed. So, eternal God, we pray for the world that our warring ways may be overturned even now through the birth, death, and resurrection of Christ, for nothing is impossible with you. We pray for the mission of your church, that we may proclaim the good news of the age as we rejoice in the gift of our Savior. We pray for all who suffer, that we may feed the hungry and lift up the lowly through the power of your holy and life-giving Spirit. We pray for your creation, that we may safeguard its well-being from generation to generation to your honor and glory. We remember before you those who have died and pray for those who will die today. We pray for those who are grieving their loss, that they may rest with you eternally in your kingdom where there is no end. Here at Emmanuel, O God, we pray for anyone who is in hospital at this time of year. Bless the sick and anyone in pain and provide a sense of your healing and comfort. For healthcare professionals seeing a rise in the number of acute respiratory infections now, bless all doctors, nurses, nurse practitioners, registered practical nurses, caregivers, that all may maintain their own health while caring for others. For all who distribute food for our tables, for all growers, raisers, fish harvesters, hunters, and trappers, that all may supply family needs. For all who work to maintain food security. For all who work to provide housing. Bless any who are homeless in this season. Lead us and guide us to do our part to find solutions to provide homes for all. For our families and friends near and far, who we hold dear to our hearts at this time of year. For any who are traveling in this season, may all reach their destinations safely and find their way home. Hear all of the prayers, O God, that we give to you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, the baby in a manger. Continue to nurture, nourish, and strengthen your people as we keep serving you faithfully. Guide us always, we pray, in the everlasting way. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us all to pray together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you, everyone, for gathering to worship this morning. We will be having coffee and conversation after our worship, so please stay and enjoy some more time with your church family and some food and a cup of tea. And as I always like to say, some sweets. May God bless you and keep you safe and serving one another faithfully, and may we meet again soon. We're going to go out singing together hymn number 73 from Voices United, "The Virgin Mary Had a Baby Boy." Let us sing together. Sending forth, friends, go now, beloved of God, and love. We keep entering into the love of the Creator for all creation. The hospitality of Jesus welcoming all people, and the friendship of the Spirit for us all. May the peace of our God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. May the blessing of our God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, abide with us now and remain with us always.
Good morning, our last time to sing carols together, except of course for tonight. There are lots of them tonight. Lots of old favorites. I asked the choir to pick today, because I don't normally look at them when I'm doing this. The first one is Away in a Manger, which is number 69. Away in a Manger, verses 1 and 3.
Away in a manger, no crib for a man, the lives are born to
one is number 91, the First Noel, verses 1 and 6. I hope with descant. After all, the choir picked it, so we should have descant. Taking part. I hope to see lots of you back tonight. There'll be lots more singing in the service. If I don't see you, then have a good Christmas to everybody, and we'll see you in the new year.